Hi everyone, my name is Moto. I'm software engineer at Facebook AI. Today, I would like to talk about Torchaudio. First, I will give the overview of the library. Then, we will look into the recent developments of the library and the community. Lastly, I will share some of the work the team is working on. Torchaudio is a library and a community for PyTorch in audio domain. Torchaudio provide building blocks for audio applications that include I/O, ops, and models. I/O operations allow to load tensor data from many audio formats and saving tensor into audio. It also supports file-like objects. Torchaudio implement many operations used in audio domain, such as digital filtering, spectrum operations, feature extractions, and beamforming. Torchaudio has model definitions and training recipes. It also has support for pre-trained weights. The reason why you want to use Torchaudio when starting an audio project is it is easy to install, it is rigorously tested, it supports Torch script. Torchaudio supports the major platform that PyTorch supports. It is tested for CPU-GPU compatibility, various data types, alt-grad correctness. We also ensure the numerical parity against popular third-party libraries. We make sure that Torchaudio supports Torch script, so that models and data preprocessing pipeline can be used in non-Python environment, such as C++ and mobile devices. Let's look at some examples. To load audio into Tensor, you can use torchaudio.load. To change the sampling rate, you can use torchaudio.functional.resample. This function also supports GPU. To save Tensor into audio format, you can use torchaudio.save. Operations in torchaudio.transforms module are implemented using PyTorch's module class. You can define the operation by instantiating a transform. Then you can pass the input tensors to perform the actual computation. Similarly, you can configure your model at the construction and run the computation by passing the input tensors. This example shows how to use spec augment. Spec augment is a popular augmentation technique. With Torchaudio, you can apply it with a few lines of code. Let's look into the recent developments. In version 0.8, we added file-like object support to I/O functions. This allows to perform on-the-fly codec application. We also adapted CMake in the build process so that the Torch scripted operations can be used in non-Python environment. In 0.9, we added the popular Wave2Vec2 model with Torch script support. We also started adapting native complex data type. In version 0.10, we added operations such as RNNT loss function and MVDR. We also supported pre-trained weight for Wave2Vec2, Tacotron2, and WaveRNN. Let's look at the examples from the recent development. Apply codec functions uses file-like object I/O under the hood, and it applies codecs without saving the tensor on file system. The pipeline API we introduced in 0.10 makes it easy to use pre-trained weights. In this example, TTS pipeline is composed of three different neural networks, which share some configuration parameters. Because it is tedious if all the users have to figure out the correct parameters and re-implement them in client code, we bundle them together. Now you can perform TTS with just a few lines of code. Let's look at the community growth. As of September 2021, there are more than 5,000 projects on github.com that use Torchaudio. If we look back, it was only 200 in July 2020. The adaptation of Torchaudio is growing. Thank you for using Torchaudio. Finally, let me share the current work the team is working on. Firstly, we are working to provide on-device ASR support. This includes model architecture with low memory footprint, such as Informer, which was developed at Facebook AI Research. We are also working to provide the beam search decoder that can work on mobile devices. We are also adding binary distribution of Torchaudio for mobiles. Lastly, we are working to promote the research and production use of self-supervised models. In this work stream, we added support for pre-trained model of Wave2Vec2 and Hubert in 0.10 release. We are working further to add components for downstream tasks, such as beam search decoder with language model support, datasets, and preprocessing used in popular downstream tasks. That's all I have today, and thank you for listening. Here are the resources for Torchaudio project. We are looking forward to your feedback. Again, thank you for using Torchaudio.